This time, I have three different images: the head skull, the snake with several angles, and the hourglass. And I look and imagine to make design like this. In this video, I'll show you how I made these three images using Adobe Photoshop into an epic t-shirt design. Without further ado, let's begin. As usual, I create new document with 35,000 by 3,000 pixels with resolution 300, and I name it T-shirt Design. I grab all image and put the document, place them and scale them in the position I want. The scan I want to make this time is, the snake seems smoothly come through between the eye socket and coils around the skull head. That's why I have several images of the same snake but with different position and angles to make it happen. I try to play around just to get the right position and cut the snake image using pen tool and positioning it on the scheme I had imagined until them look smooth, pop and real. After we've got the perfect adjustment to the skull's head, now I want to make it more stand out. And I've come with weird idea to adding a frame from the copper hourglass image. And I don't need the sound tube, I just want to frame of it. So it's if the skull head skin that we made before seems to be displayed and framed with copper hourglass frame. If you wanna see my other artwork or my work progress, quick tutorial, free asset that I use, tips and tricks using Adobe Photoshop, and other information related to photo manipulation, you can check my Instagram guys. And once a month, I will give you my artwork for free, which might be useful for those of you who are looking for design to build your own clothing business. So don't miss it. Okay guys, after the image I evolved into the scheme I want, as usual I did some color adjustment and add the shadow using the clipping mask technique and a little bit play on the channel exposure section in the adjustment layer menu. I'll paint the shadow using a regular brush and dancing using my brush all in the opposite direction to the light source. I will show you in this video guys, so stay tuned. For your information, sometimes photo manipulation needs more effort and adjust the color of all the image we have. Sometimes I play a bit on the color balance, levels, curves, hue saturation, and etc. The reason I'm doing this is just to find out the best result for this stuff, because basically I just want to make all the images that have been processed look smooth and blend together, that's all. Move on to the next step, I put a grunge texture and blood splatter on the image to get horror and spooky ambience. If you want to have the texture and blood splatter brush I use, I put the link in the description column guys, so you can get it. Let's go! Now I pick my text tool, try to make some titles, and I start by type scream. I come up with random ideas, guys, and I think scream is cool to be in the title this time. By the way, the font that I use is called Kasperak, seeing the character style of this font, which is spooky, horror, gothic typeface, and I think it fits the design very well this time. I put the download link in the description so you can download the same font as mine. Let's dive in. Voila, this is it, final result of the scream t-shirt design using Adobe Photoshop, and I'm so happy with it, so let's put it into the t-shirt mockup, so let's go! Well, maybe that's all for making a t-shirt design using Adobe Photoshop. Thank you for joining me. If you like this channel, don't forget to subscribe, like, or comment below, cause with that, give me more energy to create and share more videos for you guys. See you in the next video.